Hello and welcome back to the DuckHunter time-lapse build. This is part 14. In this segment I will be trying to rectify the less than perfect fiberglass job I did in part 13. So as you can see, the surface is very wavy. You could see the weave in some areas. Right here I'm trying to scrape off the high spots with a hand plane blade. This is a better way of smoothing down the surface because it doesn't create all that toxic fiberglass and epoxy dust. Here I'm looking for voids with a flashlight and circling them with a Sharpie. I'm then going to cut them out with the box knife. Originally, I didn't know what I wanted to do with the bottom of this boat. After doing some research, I reached out to TotalBoat and they recommended their two-part fairing compound. So I went ahead and made a purchase. Here it is right here. One part's yellow, the other part's blue, and it turns green when you've thoroughly mixed it together. And what it does is it creates a really nice smooth finish that you can sand. Here's where I could have benefited from a dust collection system. Sanding this fairing compound was just insane, as you can see. The dust went everywhere, and I mean everywhere. It's still all over my garage. It's on the shelves, and everything that's on the shelves is coated in this dust. Eventually, one day I'll shake everything off or wipe it off or whatever. as with all do-it-yourself projects that I get involved with, I don't really understand how to do it until I'm at the end of the project. So right here you can see I'm using a putty knife to try to get that compound on those external 90 degree angles, which are on the kill strips. And it was just really tedious and time consuming. And I didn't really figure out how to do it until toward the end. And what I figured out was if you take a thick stock cardboard, like from a cereal box, and just bend it, you can just glide the material right over those corners, those edges. So there's some of the cardboard there you see sitting on the boat. I'm just going to take that and fold it and run it down the edges here in a moment. There it is. So it looks like I'm coming to the end of finishing the bottom of this boat. In the next video, I'll start prepping it for painting. And that brings us to the end of this video. Okay, take care. See you in part 15. Bye-bye.